A heated tit-for-tat between the Philippines and Malaysia as both assert their claims over Sabah. Malacanang insists the territory belongs to the Philippines, but the palace says the dispute should not affect bilateral ties with Kuala Lumpur. Willard Cheng has this story.
Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Loxin Jr. is summoning the Ambassador of Malaysia as a response to the Foreign Minister of Malaysia's summons to the Philippine Ambassador to Kuala Lumpur to explain Loxin's earlier tweet that Sabah is not in Malaysia. Malaysian Foreign Minister Hishamuddin Hussein says the statement is irresponsible and affects bilateral ties. He insists Sabah is and will always be part of Malaysia. Loxin first tweeted on Monday, telling the U.S. Embassy in Manila to edit its tweet about a donation made to Filipinos returning from Sabah, Malaysia, insisting that Sabah is not in Malaysia. The U.S. Embassy did not respond, neither did it change its tweet. Despite Malaysia's reaction, Loxin stood pat, saying the Philippines has and will continue to assert its rights in the West Philippine Sea and Sabah. Loxin revealed that Malaysia had tried to derail the arbitral award that the Philippines won in The Hague, which ruled in favor of the Philippines' maritime entitlements and invalidated China's sweeping claims over the South China Sea. Malacanang, for its part, believes relations won't be affected even as the dispute over Sabah remains unresolved.
Ang Sabah po ay binigay po sa atin ng ating mga kapatid na galing sa Brunei, binigay po sa Sultanate of Cebu na inassign naman po sa Republika ng Pilipinas, but we recognize po na this matter that we should not affect our ongoing bilateral ties with Malaysia.
Maritime law expert Jay Batong Bakal finds the situation unfortunate and counterproductive at this time, especially since interests between the United States, Malaysia, and the Philippines converge in the South China Sea. Like the Philippines, Malaysia is a claimant and a party to the South China Sea disputes. While summoning ambassadors is expected and normal, Batong Bakal hopes the matter will be settled quickly and that both sides agree to disagree, since it will not do the Philippines any good if, in addition to the pandemic, another humanitarian crisis erupts from another round of mass expulsion of Filipinos from Sabah. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
Let's get more perspective from Attorney Jose Lorena on this issue. He's a member of the Bangsamoro Parliament and a former professor of Southeast Asian history. Good morning, Attorney Lorena, and thank you very much for joining us again.
Good morning, Christian, and good morning to all our TV listeners.
Before we go into the heart of the issue, let's talk about the timing of having such a dispute in the middle of a pandemic, given the realities, for example, in the South China Sea, between the Philippines and Malaysia, which started with a tweet. Do you think this is something that we are supposed to actually focus on at this time?
Well, it is unfortunate, but the issue is always there because it was the issue of Sabah was put in a back burner, and an issue which is not yet resolved will definitely come back.
Mm-mm. But basically, let's go to the issue of whether, of course, we know that the claim of the Philippines over Sabah is dormant. So at this point, what is the status of Sabah?
Well, we got my perspective. With respect to the Philippines, the perspective is that the Sabah is still being claimed by us because we are still relying on a bilateral relation as anchored on the Manila Accord. And incidentally, the Manila Accord anniversary is July 31, 1963. The Manila Accord was signed in 1963, and today is the anniversary of that accord.
Mm. So the claim is still there, but effectively, that portion is administered by Malaysia. And in fact, Sabah joined the Federation of Malaysia in 1963. So realistically, can we still how likely or realistic will our reassertion be, given the present facts there now?
Legally, we can still, because there is an honorable agreement between the parties before even the constitution of the Federation of Malaysia in 1963. We should remember that the Manila Accord guarantees that even with the inclusion of North Borneo to the Federation of Malaysia, the rights and the claim of the Philippines with respect to North Borneo will be recognized. And the pursuit for a bilateral and peaceful resolution of that should be pursued by both parties.
Do you think it's a good time to actually revive the claim, at least during this administration, in the next 2 years?
Well, in the context of the ASEAN, I think for a peaceful ASEAN, the issues which were an irritant issue should always be considered as to be resolved. Although at this point in time, because of our bilateral relation with Malaysia, we have a good relationship, then an honest-to-goodness discussion could be started on a high level, so that we will not be going to social media, we will not be going to people will not be talking about it outside the perimeter of the government government-to-government discussion. So I think that issue should still be pursued, so that within the context of a good neighbor and within the context of the United Nations and the ASEAN community.
But how exactly do you pursue that? Because we know the position of Malaysia. As far as they're concerned, there's no other claim that Sabah is theirs. They don't even entertain any statement that would approximate a claim. And they're very sensitive on this. We know that even simple or innocuous, even benign news reports or statements coming from certain government officials about the Philippine claim over Sabah, that immediately becomes big news in Kuala Lumpur. So we know how the Malaysians respond to this.
Yes, that's from the perspective of the Malaysian, because they want to hold on to their position, because the reliance on the Kobod plebiscite, which was not accepted by the Philippines, was still there. But it is for us to determine whether we continue to pursue or not to pursue, depending on our legitimate claim. So it requires a political decision, and I think both Malaysia and the Philippines should consider that there are many ways in solving a problem: negotiations, setting it to arbitration, and many other peaceful means. I don't believe that there are no avenue for discussion between good neighbors. After all, in the context of the ASEAN, we are pursuing an ASEAN family. And any problem within the family should be resolved, so that we will not have a discord within the family.
Okay. Now, in the first place, we know that a lot of people, even Filipinos, are also criticizing the Foreign Secretary Teodoro Loxin Jr. for supposedly reigniting this dispute on Twitter. But to be fair to him, is he actually wrong? He said, Sabah is not in Malaysia if you want to have anything to do with the Philippines. And then number two, he also tweeted, no country can tell another what it can and cannot say about what the latter regards as rightfully its own. So basically, is he even wrong?
He is not wrong, because he is talking from a perspective of a Filipino diplomat and a head of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, of which the issue is large. And I think the document will show that the Philippines has not abandoned that claim. Mm. So as a Philippine official, he must speak from the Philippine perspective. And from the Philippine perspective, the claim has not yet been abandoned.
Yeah, that's so true. That has to be made clear. Mm.
It is within his right to speak out as the foreign minister to explain the position of the Philippines with regards to an issue such as Sabah.
Okay, but we know that since the time that the claim of the Philippines over Sabah, or at least portions of Sabah, we're not claiming the entire territory, since it became dormant, a lot of things have changed. Now, given the position that we had before, I think we had a much stronger position then when we tried to push it at the International Court of Justice, and Malaysia didn't want to participate. But now they have been administering the territory and basically developed it. So what do you think of the Philippines' position at this point, assuming that you want to reassert our claim?
Well, I think the Philippines and Malaysia should go back to the July 31, 1963 agreement to look for a bilateral solution to the problem through peaceful means. Well, negotiations would definitely come up with certain compromises, and this can be done through face-to-face negotiation between two countries, especially good neighbors, Malaysia and the Philippines. We cannot go back to hard and fast rules of our own position, but certainly the positions of the two parties must be addressed. In a negotiation, there would be mutual, there will be addressing a favorable settlement rather than going to an arbitration, because there you have a leverage of avenue for discussion on basing on the reality, on the considering that we are now moving to an ASEAN community, and all these aspects will be considered. Negotiation will not be holding on to your own position, but making some compromises along the way. So I don't believe that an issue such as Sabah could not be addressed through peaceful dialogue between two neighbors and two friendly neighbors, and not a close neighbor.
Okay, just want to make this clear. You're not actually in favor of, let's say, pushing this again before the International Court of Justice, but instead try to resolve this bilaterally with Malaysia.
Well, I'm just saying that the parameters have been defined in the Manila Accord between Justado Macapagal and Tunod Abdulrahman on how to go about resolving the issue. And I think it was laid down there what are the means that could be done by the two countries in order to peacefully address the problem of South Borneo.
Okay, now let's go a bit back into history and why the Philippines in the first place is claiming a part of Sabah. And then how important was that supposed document, that is interpreted differently by Malaysia and the Philippines? Malaysia interprets that document as a cession, sa atin naman, we consider that as a lease.
Yes. We are referring to the 1898 Padjak Agreement between Lord Gustavo Overbeck and the Sultan of Sulu, Sultan Jamal Al-Kiram. And I think it has been raised to the International Court of Justice, and there were opinions on that matter. There were even verification made by scholars at the time on the term Pajak. But even the decision was in our favor because Pajak was interpreted by two scholars to mean as rent. Mm. However, from the perspective of the Malaysian, they said that is a permanent lease or cession. That is why even in the payment of the amount of 5,000, which was increased to 5,300, based on the December 1939 decision of Justice McCaskey of North Borneo, it is considered by Malaysia as a cession money, while we considered it as a rent. Mm. So the basis was because there was no transfer accordingly of sovereignty with respect to North Borneo. Secondly, there was also a claim because based on the Philippine position, the United States of America has even sent a note verbal stating that North Borneo was never a temporal possession of the United Kingdom that could be transferred to the Federation of Malaysia.
Yeah.
This is the position that we laid down. If you are talking of history, we gain possession and ownership of North Borneo because in the 17th century, there is a relationship between the Sultanate of North Borneo of Brunei and Sulu, and there was this accordingly history will tell us that the ownership of that piece of land was given to the Sultan of Sulu by the Sultan of Brunei for assisting in quelling a rebellion in that part of the territory.
And later on, the Sultanate assigned that to the Philippine government.
And no, because it was predated by the 1898 agreement, the Sultan of Sulu leased that, if we use the Philippine perspective, leased that to
the much later.
Huh? But later, it was transferred to, in 1962, it was transferred to the Republic of the Philippines. Mm.
So that's how the Philippine position goes. Yeah.
That was before the filing of the Philippine claim over North Borneo. I do not like to use the word Sabah because the claim was for North Borneo at that time.
Okay. Attorney Jose Lorena, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Again, thank you, Christian, and I'd like to greet everyone Happy Eid-il Mubarak, because this is Eid-il-Adha today.
Okay.
Thank you, Christian, for organizing. Thank you.